Willkommen bei Lunchroom mit Anja! Hallo alle zusammen! Hello everybody! Heute sprechen wir über typisches deutsches Essen und Trinken. Today we will talk about typical German food and drinks. So, in case you are already in Germany, then you need this video to know what you have to eat while there. And if you want to come to Germany, then it would be good if you know a few of these things, because when you see them in the street or somewhere, you can try them immediately. Okay? Los geht's! Deutsches Essen und Trinken. German food and beverages. So. Das ist ein Schnitzel. Das Schnitzel. Maybe you have heard of it. It's meat. It can be pork or also chicken or any meat. And then around it you have flour, eggs and breadcrumbs, all right? And then it gets this little crispy surrounding. And usually we eat it with potatoes and a little bit of lemon. Die Zitrone. Die Zitrone. So. Sauerbraten mit Rotkohl. So, Sauerbraten. Sauer means sour. Braten is like a roast meat, yeah? Mit Rotkohl with red cabbage. And what you see on top, those two balls, them we call Klöße. Klöße. They are a type of German dumplings. Alright? So, und dann hast du Soße. On top of it, you have sauce. Lecker! Käsespätzle. Käse means cheese, and Spätzle is a type of pasta, a type of noodles. So it's like noodles with lots of cheese. Ja, viel Käse. Sehr lecker, lecker, lecker. Aber nicht so gesund, but not so healthy. So, der Eintopf. Eintopf. So, maybe you understand this. Ein means one, no? And Topf. Ein Topf ist das. Das ist ein Topf. Der Topf. And if you have a pot and you put everything in there, meat, carrots, what else do they have here? Potatoes, so Fleisch, Kartoffeln, Möhren und so weiter. You put everything in there and you boil it and then you get ein Topf. It's like a type of soup or a kind of stew. All right? Meine Oma kocht ganz oft Eintopf. My grandma, she likes to make this, to cook this. So, Bratwurst mit Sauerkraut. I'm pretty sure you've heard of this before. So, Bratwurst, literally it means fried sausage. Braten means to fry. Wurst is a sausage. Then mit Sauerkraut, with Chucrut. And this is what you see in this picture. Die Wurst, dann ein bisschen Senf, Mustard, der Senf, Kartoffelbrei, Kartoffelbrei, it's like mashed potatoes, und Sauerkraut. Okay, und die Schwarzwälder Kirschtorte. So, it's a very long name, no? Let me say it again. Schwarzwälder Kirschtorte. So, schwarz means black. Wälder means that it belongs to a forest, yeah? Because der Wald is the forest. So it's like the Black Forest Cake, I think you call it in English. And then Kirsche, Kirsche means cherry. But we just cut it shorter so it sounds better. And then Kirschtorte, Torte is a big cake, a tart, yeah? What you see in the picture. Die Torte. Okay, sehr lecker. Ich liebe diese Torte. I love this cake. Und Bier? Ihr kennt alle deutsches Bier, oder? All of you know German beer. So, das ist ein Bild von dem Oktoberfest. This is a picture from the Oktoberfest, actually. So, and I think we have over 1,500 different types of beers or something like that. I have to look it up again, but we have so many types of beer in Germany. It's crazy. Es ist verrückt. Es ist verrückt. It is crazy. Und der Glühwein. Glühwein. Glühen means to glow. And Wein is wine. So it's like glowing wine, hot wine. Wir trinken Glühwein oft auf dem Weihnachtsmarkt. We usually drink Glühwein on the Christmas market, no? To warm up. But never mind, if you come to Germany, then you have to try it. Wenn du nach Deutschland kommst, musst du Glühwein probieren. Alles klar? Gut, super! Das ist alles? That's all. Bitte schreibe in die Kommentare, was du schon einmal probiert hast. Please write in the comments what you have tried already. So, for example, you can say, ich habe schon einmal Glühwein getrunken. Oder ich habe schon einmal Bratwurst gegessen. Okay? Oder ich habe schon einmal Schnitzel probiert. I have already tried Schnitzel. And so on. Okay? Super. Dankeschön. Tschüss.